Miss Frances sitting where she can close her. And I shiver. And I realize if I abandon the children, I have left them to their fate. No! I will stay and fight. And so it was. When the children came back, I made a special effort to be as lovely to them as I could be. And we had a merry evening playing games. And at the end of the evening, I spat on my hand and I shook it. Let us be friends again. Let us stay friends this time. And for my part, I am sorry. And they agreed. And for 3 weeks, although the house was not silent, and often I felt spirits looking down, I ignored them utterly, letting them gradually vanish into the dark. And I behaved almost as natural as I can with Miles and his sister. Only sometimes I hug them tight, wanting to match my vitality to theirs, meaning to lend them some of my power. Now, as the weeks pass, I'm sure it is safe to talk to Miles. And so, one afternoon, as his sister is practicing piano, I come in and talk to him and I say, "What did you think of Mr. Prince?"
"He was a most interesting man."
"But was he not bad?"
"I never asked myself that question."
"Have you ever seen him since?" And before he could answer, I realized he's listening. He's wondering what to say. And I suddenly listen too. And I realize I cannot hear the piano. The door is open. And so I run outside. And there she is on the other side of the lake. Miss Frances, standing, staring. And there is Flora looking at her. "Flora, come inside this once!" I call her. But in reply, she says,
"I hate you. I want another governess."
"How could you?" And I bundle her inside and I give her to Mrs. Crow to look after. And then I realize I have left Miles quite alone. And I run into the room where he is sitting and I grab hold of him, for I can feel the malevolent gaze. "Look at us! Look at us!" And Mr. Quince, I know, is in the room. And I hug Miles, meaning to give him my power, matching my heart with his, as the black locks of Mr. Quince beat down. And I start to say the Lord's Prayer in defiance. But too late, Miles' little heart.
What a chilling tale that is. And who knows who's right and who's wrong. But, clever people, I feel now the hour is coming. The host is coming. I sense his presence. I feel it in my bones. He is coming. And I'm sure that some of you, at least, will have understood what kind of man or creature he is, and what might be the bargain that he wishes to strike with you. I'm sure some of you have read it. Dear lady, take this and shine it at his forehead. Make the sign of the cross, and any holy letters that you know of. We must somehow banish him. If you would, join me in this incantation, and we shall be rid of him and drive him back. Return him. Join me, dear lady, do not be hypnotized. Join me. Return him.
Thank you.